Hello students, we come to part 2 of our lesson, video lesson on probability. So in the part 1 you have seen, I have given you the concept and I have solved 4 years ICSC questions 2020, 2019, 2018 and 17. So next we move on to, in this part 2, we move on to 2016 to 2010, except 1 year, which is 2011, where a question came on cards. So next video lesson, I'll show you this cards question. So part 3 will be my video lesson on probability on cards. And part 4, maybe I'll do more questions. We have some question in ICSC on coins and die or dice. So die or dice, they are same thing, only difference is dice is singular and die is singular and dice is plural. Okay, so die is singular and dice is plural, that we will see in part 4, and if any other miscellaneous question is there, I may have to make a fifth video lesson. So let us just recap. The main thing is probability of an event is number of favorable outcome by total number of outcome. So two books generally we use most of the time. One is concise, it is exercise 25C. And ML Agarwal, it's into exercise 22. So most of the question, ICSC questions, are same in both the books. So here we start with year 2016. So this is a solved question of 10 in ML Agarwal's book, but concise it is unsolved 35. Anyway, let us see the question. Generally, I don't do the solved question, but thing is, since I'm doing ICSC question, so some solved, unsolved. So I am trying to give you a clear picture of last 10 years, 11 years of ICSC question. Then I will move on to other ICSC question plus some other concepts where I will do some other sums, non-ICSC sums also. So here we have cards. Like you see cards, here we have the real cards. So like this cards you have, but here it's 11 to 40, so these are not cards of your colors. So these are numbered cards. Okay, so this cards you will see in my part 3. Okay, this is diamond, you will see. So four colors. So wait for my next video lesson where I'll do at least 2 to 3 question on cards. So cards like that are there and it is written 11 to 40. So you have to find the probability of getting a perfect square. So see, perfect square over here, what we will call favorable event. If you see here, favorable event is, so perfect square, don't confuse children here. You don't write 1, 4 and 9. Okay. Because your sample space is 11 to 40. So we have 16, 25 and 36, which is equal to 3. So probability of let it be event E1 of getting a perfect square is 3 by, so 11 to 40. So what is my sample space? So my sample space over here is 30. So I get 1 by 10. So you generally get 1 mark for writing either this answer gives you 1 mark. And here you can write, since place is less, sample space is 30. So there are 30, 11 to 40, we are 30. So this is very important, children, you write. favorable outcomes, we can write favorable outcomes are 3. So probability is, if you see, probability is this. Okay, so next we move on to, so always cancel in the lowest term. So next part of the question is saying that you find divisible by 7, find the probability that the number on the card is divisible by 7. Divisible by 7. So what is my favorable case? Favorable case is 7 stable, but don't take 7 because 7 is not there in this sample, so it starts with 11. So take 14, 21, 28 and 35, which is 4. So my answer, suppose PE2, in place of E2 children, you can write P divisible by 7 is 4 by 30. So we have total 30. So if you cancel, you get 2 by 15. So once more cards are there from 11 to 40. So sample space, you write 30. Favorable case, perfect square, don't take 149 because they are not here. So 16, 25 and 36. So 3 perfect square is there. Perfect squares are there between 11 to 40. So your probability is 3 by 30. Please bring it to lowest term. Simplify it. Otherwise, if you leave the answer here, you will get 0. Same way here also. Divisible by 7, don't write 7. 14, 21, 28, 35. We have sample space 4 and our favorable case is 4 and total number of cases is 30. So this was, children, you can pause the video and write. This was question for the year 2016. So here I am going from 2016-15 like that, because in the first video you saw we did 20, 19, 18, 17, 16. Now let us see. This is my ICSC 2015. So this is 2015. This, if you see, this is solved example 8 in M.L. Agrawal's book. And if you see concise, this is 34 unsolved. So unsolved 34, if you see concise book, and M.L. Agrawal, you have solved 8. What is the question? Very simple question, a bag, and sometimes you will see we have a box which have 5 white balls, 6 red balls, 9 green balls. So what is total number of balls? 20. What is the probability of getting a green ball? So you can write P1, E1 is getting a green ball, is equal to, green is how many? 9. And what is my, this is my sample space. Sample space is 20. Means this is what we call, another name of total number of outcome is we call sample space also. So anything you can use, they are one and same. So some of you are comfortable with these two words, and some of you write this. So sample space is total 20 over here, children. A white ball or a red ball. So what is our favorable case here? White ball or red. So how many? So our favorable cases, number of favorable cases or outcome is white or red. 5 plus 6, 11. White or red you will get. So 5 plus 6. So probability E2 is 11 by 20. So So here you see white or red ball. If you see, you simply add, because it is either a white or a red ball. So 11 by 20. Third one is very interesting. Neither a green nor a white means we are talking about a neither green nor white. Neither green nor white means we are talking about number of red balls. So red balls, how many? We have 6. So we write probability of getting red balls or neither a green ball or a white ball means red ball is 6 by, red ball is 6 by 20. If you bring to lowest term, it is 3 by 10. So remember, neither a green nor a white means it's a red ball. Red ball is 6 by 6 red balls are there out of 20. So you can pause the video, take a screenshot and copy. Then we move on to next 2 years ICSC question. So now we go to question from ICSC 2014. What we have? A die. So sometime you get confused, children. Die means singular. You play Ludo. What you have generally is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But this has 3 positive integer. If you see number line, this has 3 negative integer without 0. So these are the 6 faces of a die what you have got in this question. And plural of die is dice. So 2 and more when you throw, it's called a dice. A singular is called a die. Anyway, that's the language part of it. So you have all played Ludo when you were small. So this is what we are doing. Cards are the new thing. Many of you don't know. So as I said, we will see in the next part. Cards question which came in, I think, ICSC 2011. Only once it has come, I think. So 2011, today I am not going to do that. We will do in part 3 of my video lessons. So here we have this. So a die has 6 faces. So children, first thing is, first you write what is sample space. So sample space means total number of outcome is 6. Okay, so sometimes this carries, each one carries 1 mark. And if it is a 4 mark question, you will get 1 mark for this. So generally in probability, there is 1 question in ICSC, either in section A, like we saw in 2020 I've solved, or it is in section B, so it is generally 3 mark and each part carries 1 mark. So C are a positive integer. So out of 6, P E1, you can call E1 is positive integer, you write in place of E1 a positive integer. So what is that? These 3 are positive out of 6. So 3 are positive out of 6. Answer is half. If you don't reduce to lowest term, children, you get 0. An integer greater than minus 3. If you see greater than minus 3, these are all big. So if you see number line, minus 3 is here, minus 2, okay, minus 1. So all these on the right side are greater, but remember 0 is not there. So integer greater than minus 3 is actually what? Minus 2, minus 1, 1, 2, 3, which is 5. So we have altogether favorable case. So number of favorable outcome, okay, number of favorable outcome is 5, so your answer is 5 by 6. So greater than minus 3, these are all greater than minus 3. So out of 6, 5. So 5 by 6 is the probability. Smallest integer is minus 3. So what is our favorable case? Only 1 minus 3. So answer is 1 by 6. So smallest integer minus 3 out of 6. So you can write here one line, number of favorable cases 1, in bracket you can write minus 3. So this was year 2014. Now we move on to one of the my favorite question, because this is a little tricky. This is not very hard, and this is solved in M.L. Agarwal's book, Question 17, but it is unsolved in concise book, Question 31, but the hint is given. Almost they have solved the question. So very interesting question. Some balls are there in a box, some black balls and 30 white balls. So let the black balls be X. So they are saying some balls, so we let the black balls be X and white balls are given 30. Now we have to find the number of black balls, but what is given? The probability of black ball. So probability of black ball, if you see black ball by the sample space. So out of X, okay, and 30 white balls. So what is probability of black ball? X by X plus 30 is 2/5 of white ball. So white ball is what? 30 by X plus 30. X plus 30 is sample space. So you can write over here. I'm rubbing this. Please copy. This is important. So sample space children is here X plus 30. X black balls plus 30 white balls. So some of you cross multiply and solve, but remember this two denominator will cancel. Some of you make it big, then you make it small. So if you cancel, no problem. We get 5x is equal to 60. X is equal to 12. 60 by 5. So X is 60 by 5, which is 12. So there are 12 black balls. And if you put the value of fx is equal to 12 in the equation, then definitely you will get the answer. So please pause the video and copy. So children, we move on to year 2012. So the last question what I did was 2013, where we had some black balls we had to find and we got 12 as the answer. I hope you have copied. One of the very interesting questions which I ever saw in ICSE. Okay, so 2012, two coins are tossed once. Children, two coins are tossed once is also same as one coin is tossed twice. So two coins when you put, so what is the sample space? So we get two heads. So what is the sample? You write below, I am writing it up. Sample space is, children, 4. You will say, sir, how? In both the coin you get head, two coins are tossed. Then head, tail, then tail, head, then tail, tail. So these are the four possibilities. Once more, one coin shows you head, other also shows you head. First head, second tails, and third one, first tail, second coin head, and the last one, both coin tails. So two heads. So two heads, what you get? Probability of let even be getting two heads is 1 by 4. Two heads. At least one tail. So remember children, these are all one tail. So here sample space remains 4. Our favorable case is 3. So number of favorable case or outcome is 3. See how HT at least one tail, not both the tail, at least. So maybe two tails, maybe one tail only. So there are three possibilities. This has one tail, this has one tail, and even when you have two, it has one tail at least. Okay, and sometime we will see some tricky question, at most. So this is at least. So that's what I tell you, we will deal later on. So probability E2 of getting at least one tail is 3 out of same sample space 4. So this was year 2012. Now 2011 children, we have cards question. So I told you I have got cards. Okay, so we will see in my next part. So we have spade. You can see these are diamond. This is club. This is club. Okay, spade. This is heart. Okay, this red colored. So I'll do that sum in my part 3. So I'm leaving 2011 because it needs little time. So 5-7 minutes I need to explain to you about cards, playing cards, and then we can go to questions. So I'm doing last question for today's session, where we have got cards which are numbered from 1 to 20. Okay, so 1 to 20 we have. This is ML Agarwal's question 19. So first question is, how many prime numbers you have? So children, here you need to have a very good idea of prime numbers. So what are the prime numbers? So number of favorable cases is, outcome or cases is, 1 is not a prime, children. Starts with 2, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9 is not a prime number. 9 has a factor 3, 11, 13, 17 and 19. So what do you see? We have 8 prime numbers out of first 20. So my probability of getting a prime number from this sample space. So sample space, children, is here. This total number of outcomes. Sample space is nothing but total number of outcomes. So sample space is 20 over here. So my answer is, this is nothing but 8. Okay, so 8 by your prime numbers, these are 8. So see here, your concept of prime number is being tested. If you don't know prime number, your 1 mark will go. So 8 by 20, when you cancel by 4, 2's are, 5's are. So answer is 2 by 5. Number divisible by 3. So what are the number divisible by 3? So our favorable case is, number of favorable cases is here. What we have, children? Multiple of 3 between 1 and 20. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. So we have all together, I think, 3 and 3, 6. So you can check nicely, we have 6 numbers out of, so probability of getting divisible by 3 numbers, which are divisible by 3 between 1 to 20. So you can write PE1, E2, or you can write, when they are small, you can write the full thing. So it is your 6 by 20, and if you cancel, you will get 3 by 10. So next answer is your 3 by 10. And the last one, perfect square, children, we have. So what are the perfect squares? So favorable case, number of favorable outcome, if you see. Okay. Outcome or cases is perfect square, means 1, 4, 9, 16. Okay. So there are 4 perfect square numbers between 1 to 20, because 25 is more than 20. So my probability of getting a perfect, so P means probability and perfect square, you could have written E2, even like that, even E2, E3, is 4 by 20, which is 1 by 5. So I think this question carried 3 marks, and you will get all 3 marks. But remember, your sample space has to be right. 1 mark, 1 mark, 1 mark, you will get 2 by 5, 3 by 10, and 1 by 5. So this was year 2010. So I have solved all from 2010 to 2020 in my part 1 and part 2 of my video lesson on probability. So part 3, if you have any doubt in cards question. So as I told you, this cards question I am going to deal in my part 3. I'll try to do questions a little bigger. So maybe 2 to 3 question I'll do to clarify your concept. Okay, then part 4, we will see coin and dice or die question I told you, and miscellaneous type of question. So please copy, children. Pause the video, take screenshot and copy this. And thank you, boys, for watching this video lesson on probability.